I want to talk to you today about healing words. Our words have the power to lift people, to help them get through a challenge, to push them into their destinies. When you tell someone, I love you, I'm proud of you, you did great on that project, you're not just being kind. These are healing words. We don't know what people are going through. They might smile on the outside, but on the inside, they're hurting. They're lonely. They're discouraged. Many people have wounds from the past, wounds from a relationship that didn't work out, wounds from people trying to push them down. Just a simple word of encouragement. I believe in you. I'm praying for you. A simple compliment. You look beautiful today. It's no big deal to you, but to them, it's helping them heal the wounds. It's lifting their spirits. It's causing them to believe in themselves. Your words can be what keeps them moving forward. God puts people into our lives on purpose so we can bring healing. The security guard at the office. Don't just pass by him every day for the next 20 years. Take the moment to bless him with your words. You don't have to spend 10 minutes, just a simple, great to see you today. I appreciate you taking care of us. You've just spoken a blessing over his life. Letting people know that you care does more than you can imagine because we live in a society that's filled with a lot of negative chatter through the internet, social media. It's becoming normal to be disrespectful. People think nothing of being condescending, saying hurtful, critical things. More than ever, people need your healing words. You have the power to put someone on their feet. You have the power to keep them from falling into depression. You have the power to cause them to pursue their dreams. But without your blessing, without your encouragement, your compliments, they won't become what they should have become. Don't miss these opportunities. Don't be too caught up in your own career, in your challenges. Take time to be a healer, to be a lifter. God needs you. He has no voice to encourage on earth except for your voice. He's counting on you to help heal the people in your life. When someone does something good for me, when they're kind, I'm grateful. Of course, I tell them thank you, but when somebody does something good for my children, when they go out of their way to help them in a time of need, as a parent, there's nothing I won't do for them. That's the way God is. When you go out of your way to bless one of his children, when you make it your business to encourage the coworker that's down, when you stop by to see a friend that's not feeling well, when you call your relative just to say you love them because you're taking care of his children, God will make sure somebody is always there to take care of you, to bring healing, to bring that encouragement, to show you favor. Those are seeds that you're sowing. Look around at who's in your life. The clerk at the grocery store, the coworker on Zoom, the friend at the gym. They're not there by accident. They need what you have. They need encouragement. They need affirmation. They need to know that you believe in them. Don't keep the healing to yourself. Be free with compliments. A blessing is not a blessing until it's spoken. Your thoughts don't bless anybody. You can think well of your friend all day long, but if you never tell them, they'll never know. No matter how many times you compliment a person, when that thought comes up, tell them again. That's God bringing it up. You don't know what they're going through. You don't know the battles they're fighting, the people trying to push them down. God wouldn't have brought it up to you if he didn't want you to tell them. These days, it's easier than ever. If you're not there in person, you could send them a text. Hey, I want you to know I love you, and I think you're beautiful. The scripture says a gentle tongue brings healing. When we think of healing, many times we think of praying for people for healing. And yes, that's one way. But what I want us to see is your words have healing. When you're kind, when you're encouraging, when you don't just think something good, but you verbalize it, you're being a healer. It's amazing what one kind word can do. We don't think anything about it, but to the other person, it breathes life into their spirit. If you saw someone that was sick, They were fighting an illness and you had the cure. You had the medicine that would cause them to get well. You would be quick to get it to them. You'd go over as fast as you could. Here, take this right now. I don't want you to suffer anymore. That's the way you need to see your compliments, your kind words, your encouragement. It's the healing that people need. Don't withhold it. Don't try to reason it out. Well, if they look like they're doing fine, they don't need my encouragement. You're looking on the outside. You don't know what's happening on the inside. I've learned everyone is going through something. Even the people that look like they have it all together, that they're so happy, so blessed, so strong. Can I tell you, they don't have it all together. There's always something that they're dealing with. We don't understand the power of a simple compliment. The power of, I believe in you. You're gonna make it. Great things are in store for you. Somebody today needs your healing words. Somebody won't get past that depression without you speaking blessings over them. Somebody will give up on a dream. They'll get talked out of God's best unless you step up and encourage them. Will you be a healer? Will you use words to lift people? Proverbs 18 says, our words can be life-giving water. I found people are thirsty. They've gone through heartaches. They've been beaten down by life. We have something to offer them. Our words can help heal their hearts. Be aware of who's in your life. Be sensitive to what you're feeling down in here. Take time to let people know that you care. Nobody is in your life by accident. Don't ignore what you feel on the inside. That compassion to encourage them, that desire to be their friend, they're thirsty. You have the water. Take time to make them feel loved. Doesn't have to be something big, just good to see you. I believe in you. I'm praying for you. Just let them know that you care. We're so busy these days, we've got our own challenges. If we're not careful, we'll pass right by the thirsty people. There's no greater feeling than to give them water. Nothing is more rewarding than to help someone else rise higher. When you come to the end of your life, we can be known for a lot of things. We were successful in our career. She was so talented. They lived in a nice place. That's all good. Nothing wrong with that. But I'd rather people say about me, John was a healer. He lifted me when I was down. He encouraged me when I felt stuck. He told me I could accomplish my dreams that I never thought I could accomplish. Where are the healers? Where are the lifters? There are enough people saying negative, critical, judgmental words. Our attitude should be, who can I bless today? Who can I help heal? Who can I make feel better about themselves? Why don't you start with your own family? How long has it been since you told people in your life, I love you, I'm glad you're mine? Don't let a stranger compliment your spouse more than you do. Don't let a coach, a teacher, a friend make your children feel more special than you do. Every day, bless your children with your words. Tell them how proud you are of them. Tell them what they can become. Call out their seeds of greatness. Remind them that they're made in the image of Almighty God, that they are full of potential, that they are supposed to go further than you. That anointing is increasing with each generation. They have so much to deal with these days, the social chatter and the bullying, the hurtful words. But when you tell your child, I love you, I'm blessed to have you as my child, that's not only helping to heal the wounds, but that's protecting them. That's what causes those hurtful words to bounce right off of them. The more people speak negative over you and your family, your friends, the more you need to speak these positive, faith-filled, healing words. When you compliment someone in front of people, it carries more weight. Yes, there are times you need to do it in private, but when you can, speak a blessing in public. Your blessing, your encouragement can be what causes them to step up to be who they were created to be. Your destiny is connected to the people God's put in your life. If you're going to reach your full potential, this is not an option. Look around. Who can you bless? Who can you help heal? Who can you show favor to? A man opened his front door one morning and was about to go out and get his newspaper. But the dog from across the street was sitting on the front porch with the newspaper in his mouth. The man was pleasantly surprised. He didn't have to go to the curb to get it. He started petting the dog and praising him. He went in and got a treat, came back and brought it to the dog. Next morning, the man opened the door and there was 8 newspapers on his front porch. The dog had gone from house to house picking up the different newspapers. Like that animal, we respond to praise. What am I saying? Everyone needs encouragement. Everyone needs someone that's cheering them on. Look around this week. Live with the attitude, who can I bless? Who can I help heal? Who can I push into their destiny? If you'll develop this habit of speaking healing words, I believe and declare you're not only going to help others to rise higher, but those seeds are going to come back to you. God is going to cause you to rise higher. You're going to accomplish your dreams, overcome obstacles, and become everything God created you to be in Jesus' name.